press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, how are you all? Hope all are fine and safe in your home. And in today's class, we are going to learn the new lesson of your class 5 English called Gulliver's Travels. Okay, what is the name of your lesson? Yes, that is Gulliver's Travels. Okay, after reading this lesson, you will able to know the different kinds of characters in this story and also meanings of difficult words. Okay, and you can increase your imagination and reading skills after reading this story. Okay, firstly, what do you mean by autobiography? What do you mean by autobiography? Yes, autobiography is a story of a person and which has written by his own words. Have you understood? The story of his life which is written in words. Okay, that person's that story is called as autobiography. So this Gulliver's Travels is also an autobiography of Gulliver, which is adapted from Jonathan Travels. Okay, Jonathan Swift's Gulliver's Travels. Jonathan Swift's Gulliver's Travels is the initial book after this story. Understood this? Okay, let's get started. Okay, before going to start this lesson, and I want to give a brief introduction about this story. So, Gulliver Travels is a story which is written by his own. Who is the sailor here? Gulliver. Okay, what do you mean by sailor? Sailor is a person who travels in the ship around the world. Okay, he's called sailor. Here in this story also, Gulliver is a sailor. So by being a sailor, what are the experiences he had? Okay, being a sailor, what are the experiences he had in that particular places? He written as a book, and that is a autobiography of him. Okay, so a part of that autobiography is given for you guys. Understood this? Okay, Gulliver anoba navika irtane. Sailor means kannadadalli now navika anta heli karithivi. Navika andre yaru? Sadakala hadagalli prayana madatakkantavanu. ಹಡಗಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಯಾಣ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೊಸ ಹೊಸ ಜಾಗಗಳನ್ನು ಪತ್ತೆ ಹಚ್ಚೋದು, ಅಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಜೀವಿಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ನಾವಿಕನ ಕೆಲಸ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಗಲಿವರ್ಸ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಸ್ಟೋರಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಗಲಿವರ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಬ್ಬ ನಾವಿಕ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ. ಆ ನಾವಿಕ ತನ್ನ ಆತ್ಮಕಥೆಯನ್ನು ಬರಿತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ. ಅದರ ಹೆಸರು ಜೊನಾಥನ್ ಸ್ಟಿಫ್ಸ್ ಗಲಿವರ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ. ಏನೋ ಆತ್ಮಕಥೆ ಅಥವಾ ಆತ್ಮಚರಿತ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಯಾರು ತಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನ ಕಥೆಯನ್ನು ತಾವೇ ಬರೆದುಕೊಳ್ತಾರೋ ಬುಕ್ಕಲ್ಲಿ, ಆ ಒಂದು ಕಥೆಗೆ ನಾವು ಆತ್ಮಕಥೆ ಅಥವಾ ಆತ್ಮಚರಿತ್ರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಕರಿತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀವಿ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆನಾ? ಓಕೆ, ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್. ಓಪನ್ ಪೇಜ್ ನಂಬರ್ 116, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ 116. ಗಲಿವರ್ಸ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ಸ್. ವೆನ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಟೆಲ್ಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಓನ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಆಟೋಬಯೋಗ್ರಫಿ. ಗಲಿವರ್, ಅ ಸೈಲರ್, was once caught in the land of giants. This is how he describes his experience. So, as I told earlier, autobiography is when a person tells the story of his own life in his own words. It is called as autobiography. Gulliver, a sailor. He is a sailor. He once caught in the land of giants. Okay, in the land of giants, he once caught it. And this is how it describes that experience. When he caught in the giant's land, then he experiences some incidents. So he gives the explanation of that experiences in this lesson. Okay. On the 16th of June 1730, we discovered land. Our captain sent a dozen men with vessels of water, if any could be found. When we came to land, we saw no river or spring nor any inhabitants. I went on to explore. The country was barren and rocky. I turned back to join the crew only to see them getting into the boat and rowing for life to get to the ship. Before I could reach them, I observed a huge creature walking after them in the sea. As fast as he could, the water of the ocean reached only till his knees. However, the monster was unable to overtake the speeding boat. I turned back quickly and climbed up a steep hill with fields of barley on either side and the corn rising up to 40 feet. There was a fence to pass from one field to another. So, from till this, we are going to study in this class. So, as I told earlier, this lesson is about the experiences of the Gullivers in that giant's land, when he caught in that land. On the 16th June 1730, we discovered land. On 16th June 1730, we discovered a land. Here, we refers to the whole team. Gulliver is not alone. Gulliver didn't go that place alone. He has his team, his captain. Okay? So, on 16th June 1730, can you imagine? 16th June 1730, they reached a land. They find a land. Understood this? Okay. In 1757, I think so. And Vasco da Gama found out the India. Right? Christopher Columbus found America. Sorry, that West India. West Indies or West Africa. Okay, South Africa. And Amerigo Vespucci find out America. So like this, in that period, the traveling in the ship is very common for the people. So like this, Gulliver also travels through the ship with his team. And on 16th June 1730, they discovered a land. So there is a land which is discovered by this Gulliver and his team on 16th June 1730. Our captain sent a dozen men with vessels for water if any could be found. So, they are very thirsty. They want water for their thirsty. Okay? So, the captain of Gulliver's team, there is a captain for Gulliver team, he sent a dozen men. Dozen means 12 men. He sent a dozen men to find out any water is available with giving so many vessels. You know vessels? Those are the equipments which was used to carry water. So, the captain of the Gulliver's team sent dozen of men to fetch the, to take the water in the vessels. Understood this? Next, when we came to land, we saw no river or spring nor any inhabitants. Okay, inhabitants means, write down, inhabitants means occupants. Inhabitant means occupants. Okay. We are living in Davangere and we are the inhabitants of this Davangere. Understood this? Those people who are lives in the particular place for so many years are called inhabitants of that particular place. So like this, when Gulliver's captain sent dozen men to bring the water with the vessels, then they see in the land that there is no river, there is no lake, there is no springs, and there is no inhabitants. There is no people around there in that particular land. Understood this? When Gulliver's captain sent them to fetch out the water, then they will found out that in this land there is no inhabitants, there is no river, there is no springs, there is no water content in this land. Next, what happened? I went on to explore. The country was barren and rocky. So explore means travel in order to know. Explore means travel in order to know. Can you able to see here? Okay. Explore means travel in order to know. When Gulliver and his mates found out that there is no lake, there is no river, there is no spring, and there is no inhabitants in that particular region, then Gulliver wants to find out the truth, or he knows about something about that particular place. So he went somewhere in that place. Okay. The country was barren and rocky. Barren means a land with no vegetation. Okay, write down there. Barren means a land with no vegetation. Means in that land there is no crops are grown. Okay, so that land is very barren and it is filled with rocks. It is very rocky place. Understood this? So there is, because there is neither river nor any stream, so that land becomes rocky and barren. So means a land with no vegetation. There is no crops are grown in that particular land. I turned back to join the crew only to see them getting into the boat and rowing for life to get to the ship. Okay, crew means a group of people who works in the ship. Crew means a group of people. So children, Gulliver is separated from his team because he wants to explore that land. So he went through that land. But when he turned back to ship, then he saw a crew. Crew means what? It is a group of the people who works in the ship. He saw a crew and only to see them getting into the boat and rowing for life to get to the ship. So means rowing is actually a sport. It is a sports game, right? So here what happens? Gulliver and his teammates were separated now, and those teammates were hurrying to get in that ship. Those see that they will become a very hurry in nature. And before I could reach them, I observed a huge creature walking after them in the sea as fast as he could. So, in that sea, Gulliver wants to reach that ship or boat. But before he could reach that ship, he observed a huge creature walking after them in the sea as fast as he could. Here, he observed a huge creature. Huge means very big. You know that huge is big. Creature means organism. He is also man. He is very big. A huge creature is seen in that sea, and he observed that huge creature walks as possible as can. Okay, as soon as can, he walk through that ship. So all his teammates hurry to protect their life by getting into that ship. Okay, understood this? Next. The water of the ocean reached only till his knees. However, the monster was unable to overtake the speeding boat. So, that monster is very big in size. That sea water is up to only his knees. Do you know? The sea water is very deep. When we go some distance in the sea, we will feel like, yes, we will become dead. So, like this, the sea water is there. But that sea comes only his knees. Understood this? Can you imagine how large he became? How large he has been? So, he walks towards that boat. So, that boat is also going very fast. So, he can't reach that boat. Even though he's very big, he can fast as soon as possible, but then also he couldn't take that boat, okay? Because that boat is also very speed. I turned back quickly and climbed up a steep hill with fields of barley on either side and corn rising up to 40 feet. So, Gulliver became very fearful. He's frightened by seeing that monster-looking man. Monster means a evil, a ugly, a large, a big man. Okay? He's very cruel and very frightened man. By seeing this monster, that Gulliver become very fearful, very frightened. So, he turned back and go back in hurry. He climbed a steep hill. Steep means having curves, means up and down in perpendicular manner. Slope is like in a vertical. Okay? You can see in that place there is a land or there is a hill that is very steep. When Gulliver is very fearful, then he climbed that steep hill, and that steep hill having either side growing. One side core and another side barley. And that core is grow up to 40 meters. Can you imagine? 40 feet. We are about 6 feet, 5 feet, right? So, 40 feet means we can't imagine like that, right? So, that corn is also growing like anything, and on the other side, that steep hill has barley crop. Okay? Next, there was a fence to pass from one field to other. Fence means it is a barrier or compound. Okay? There is a fence is there between two fields. We can go by crossing that field into the another field. Understood this? Gulliver ಮತ್ತೆ ಅವನ ಟೀಮ್ಮೇಟ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೋಗ್ತಿದ್ದಾಗ ಎಷ್ಟನೇ ತಾರೀಕದು 1730 ಜೂನ್ 16 1730 ರಂದು ಅವರು ಒಂದು ಪ್ರದೇಶಕ್ಕೆ ತಲುಪ್ತಾರೆ ಅವರು ಒಂದು ಭೂಮಿಗೆ ತಲುಪ್ತಾರೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ಟೀಮ್ನಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಟನ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನೀರನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡ್ಬರ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಒಂದು ಡಜನ್ ಜನರನ್ನ ಒಂದು 12 ಜನರನ್ನ ವೆಸಲ್ಸ್ನ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಬಾಟ್ಲು ಆ ಥರ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಅವನು ಆ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಗೆ ಕಳಿಸ್ತಾನೆ ಆ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಜನರಲ್ಲಿ ಗಲಿವರ್ ಕೂಡ ಒಬ್ಬ ಆದರೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ಲ್ಯಾಂಡಲ್ಲಿ ಆ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯಾದಂಥ ನದಿ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯಾದಂಥ ಸ್ಪ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಅಥವಾ ಜರಿ ಕೂಡ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯ ವಾಟರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಕೂಡ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಓಕೆನಾ ಇದನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದ ಎಲ್ಲ ಗಲಿವರ್ ಟೀಮ್ಮೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಶ್ಚರ್ಯಗೊಳ್ತಾರೆ ಗಲಿವರ್ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರ್ ಗಲಿವರ್ಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಇದನ್ನ ಹೇಗಿದು ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಅವನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಈ ಥರ ಇದೆ ಈ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಆ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣವಾಗಿ ಬಂಜರು ಭೂಮಿಯಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ನೆಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯಂತ ಒಂದು ಬೆಳೆಗಳು ಬೆಳೆದಿರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದು ಮತ್ತೆ ಫುಲ್ ರಾಕ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಕಲ್ಲು ಬಂಡೆಗಳಿಂದ ತುಂಬಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಪ್ರದೇಶ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆನಾ, ಇದನ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಗಲಿವರ್ ತನ್ನ ಟೀಮ್ ಇಂದ ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ. ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನೋಡಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹೊತ್ತಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅವನು ಬೋಟ್ ಕಡೆಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನೋಡಿದಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲೇನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ತನ್ನ ಟೀಮ್ ಮೇಟ್ಸ್ ಬೋಟನ್ನ ಆತುರಾತುರವಾಗಿ ಹತ್ತುತ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ ಹಡಗನ್ನ ಆತುರಾತುರವಾಗಿ ಹತ್ತುತ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಗಲಿವರ್ ಸರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಆಗಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಬ ಬೃಹದಾಕಾರವಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಒಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ. ಆ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬೃಹದಾಕಾರವಾಗಿರ್ತಾನೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸಮುದ್ರದ ನೀರು ಅಷ್ಟು ಆಳ ಇದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅವನಿಗೆ ಅದು ತನ್ನ ಮೊಣಕಾಲಿನವರೆಗೂ ಮಾತ್ರ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಿದೇನ? ಅಷ್ಟು ಬೃಹದಾಕಾರವಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಅವನು ಆಗಿರ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದಿಸ್? ಆಗ ಗಲಿವರ್ಗೆ ತುಂಬಾನೇ ಭಯ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಏನ್ ಈ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಹಿಂಗಿದ್ದಾನೆ ಅಂತಂದು. ಆಗ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಶಿಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಗಲಿವರ್ನ ಟೀಮ್ ಮೇಟ್ಸ್ ಹತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ ಒಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಆ ಬೃಹದಾಕಾರವಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ರಾಕ್ಷಸನ ರೀತಿ, ಮಾನ್ಸ್ಟರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ರಾಕ್ಷಸ, ರಾಕ್ಷಸನ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಹಿಡಿಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಆ ಬೋಟ್ ಹಿಂದೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ. ಆದ್ರೆ ಬೋಟ್ ಕೂಡ ತುಂಬಾ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಆ ರಾಕ್ಷಸ ಮನುಷ್ಯನಿಗೆ ಆ ಬೋಟ್ ಸಿಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಇದನ್ನ ನೋಡಿದ ಗಲ್ಲಿವರಿಗೆ ಭಯ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅವನು ಈ ರಾಕ್ಷಸನಿಂದ ತಪ್ಪಿಸ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಹಿಂದೆ ಬರ್ತಾನೆ. ಅಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಸ್ಟೀಪ್ ಹಿಲ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಉಬ್ಬು ತಗ್ಗು ಪ್ರದೇಶಗಳಿಂದ ಕೂಡಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರದೇಶ, ಒಂದು ಬೆಟ್ಟ ಗುಡ್ಡ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ, ಒಂದು ಬೆಟ್ಟ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಿದ್ದ? ಒಂದು ಗುಡ್ಡಗಾಡಿನ ಪ್ರದೇಶ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅವನೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಅದನ್ನ ಹತ್ತೋಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ತನ್ನನ್ನು, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅವನು ಹತ್ತೋಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಆ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟೀಪ್ ಹಿಲ್ಲಲ್ಲಿ, ಒಂದು ಸ್ಲೋಪ್ ಇಳಿಜಾರಿನ ಪ್ರದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಸೈಡ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಸೈಡ್ ಬಾರ್ಲಿಯನ್ನು ಬೆಳೆದಿದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸೈಡ್ ಕಾರ್ನ್ ಮೆಕ್ಕೆಜೋಳವನ್ನು ಬೆಳೆದಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್, 40 ಫೀಟ್ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಬೆಳೆ ಯಾವ ಥರ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ? ನಾವು ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ 5-6 ಫೀಟ್ ಇರ್ತೀವಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ನಮ್ಮ 6ರಷ್ಟು, ನಾವೀಗ 5 ಫೀಟ್ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಅಂದರೆ ನಮ್ಮ 6ರಷ್ಟು ಎತ್ತರದಲ್ಲಿ ಆ ಮೆಕ್ಕೆಜೋಳ ಬೆಳೀತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆಯ? ಅಷ್ಟು ಎತ್ತರದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಬೆಳೆಯನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಈ ಒಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯರು ತಿಂತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಇದನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದ ಗಲಿವರಿಗೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ತುಂಬ ಸರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಏನು ಈ ಥರ ಇದೆ ಈ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ. ಅದಾದಮೇಲೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಅವರು ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಫೀಲ್ಡಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ, ಒಂದು ಫೀಲ್ಡಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ಮಧ್ಯ ಅಡ್ಡ ಎಂದು ಬೇಲಿಯನ್ನು ಹಾಕಿದರು. ಫೆನ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಒಂದು ಬ್ಯಾರಿಯರ್, ತಡೆಗೋಡೆಯನ್ನು ನಿರ್ಮಿಸಿದರು. ನಾವು ಹೊಲದಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಬೇಲಿ ಹಾಕ್ತೀವಿ, ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಟ್ತೀವಿ, ತಂತಿ ಬೇಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹಾಕ್ತೀವಿ. ಅದೇ ಥರ ಆ ಒಂದು ಫೀಲ್ಡಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರದೇಶದ ಒಂದು ಫೀಲ್ಡಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ ಥರ ಒಂದು ಬ್ಯಾರಿಯರ್ನ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದನ್ನು ದಾಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗಬೇಕಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆಯಾ? ಓಕೆ, ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ. ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.